on Learnyst product tutorials, and in this video we will see how you can use the power of learning analytics reports to provide better support and guidance for your students. Let us get started. First, let us go to your admin dashboard and click on reports. Within reports, click on the learning analytics reports, and here you will get learning analytics reports for your courses, mock tests, bundles and test series. Let us click on your courses report. You can use the select products bar to make the search easier. Just click on the search bar and select the course of your choice. Next, let us click on the course. Here you will find the learner details like email, mobile number, their enroll date, enroll type, course completion percentage, expiry date and so on. To add or hide any of these fields, you can use the three dots on the extreme right to select or unselect any of these fields. Use the record per page to view up to 300 student records in a single page. Next, to view how many students have completed at least 25% of your course, use the filters option on the top. Click on the filters and click on new filter condition. Now click on select a filter and select the lesson completed count. And now select the greater than condition. Next, on the value field, enter the lesson count. For example, this course has 41 lessons. So 25% of 41 will be 11 lessons. So let me go ahead and enter the value of 11 in this field. To download the details, click on the export option and select the currently displayed columns to export the learner details. You can also choose all columns option to get more details about the learner. As soon as you click on export, the learner details will be sent to your admin email ID. You can also use this data to create a group. For example, you can create a group called Active Group and add all these students into a group. You can later use this group to market offers or special deals to your active students. Quizzes report offer you two types of reports. One report is focused on learner performance and the other report is about sectional quiz performance. Select the section quizzes report. This gives you the analytics of section quizzes you have created in your course, like the total sections in your course, count of published and unpublished quizzes within each section. Scroll down and you can see quiz performance within each section, like top score, average time taken to submit the quiz and so on. You can further click on the quiz to view more detailed analytics about overall performance of students in this particular quiz, like students spread over score percentage, performance at question level, etc. Use this data to analyze which quizzes have worked well for your students and which quizzes they struggled with. Choose the learner quizzes report. Select a quiz and click on the show quizzes report button at the bottom. Here you can see the performance of individual students. Next, let us explore the learning analytics within mock tests. Just like in the courses report, you can pick the mock test by scrolling through the list or by using the search bar on the top. To view the analytics within a test, let us click on a test. Here, you will be able to see the bird's eye view of your learner performance, like learner average score percentage, and the total number of learners who took the test. To view the performance of learners on the latest attempt, click on the drop-down and select the latest attempt option. Next comes the grading report. This graph right here will reveal details like what percentage of students in the test scored less than 10 marks and what percentage of students scored more than 50 marks. Below the grading report, we will have the progress report. Here, you will get to know how many students are currently writing the test, how many of them have submitted the test, and how many have exceeded the exam time, and how many have aborted the test. To get to know the summary of scores across the test sections, use the score summary report. This gives you metrics like score, answer completion speed, time spent, score percentage, and overall test performance. To get detailed analytics at question level, such as what percentage of students have answered each question correctly, use the answer distribution report. For MCQ questions, you can see what percentage of students have chosen option 1 as right answer and what percentage of students have chosen option 2 as a right answer, and so on. Note that the percentage shown in green color signifies the correct answer. Lastly, if you want to assess individual students, then you can click on the test takers report on the top right corner. You can also export individual student reports if you want to analyze the test performance of a particular student. To export the student data, click on the export button and select all columns or currently displayed columns. Next comes the bundle report. A bundle is a way to group your courses, mock test, or test series in a single package. The bundle report allows you to download learner enrollment details within bundles. If you have put multiple courses within bundles, use the filter by course option to filter out learner enrollment details per course. Please note that you can view only the enrollment details of learners in bundles. To know how the learners have performed within the courses and mock test, please go to the respective courses and mock test reports. You can also export the details of learners enrolled to your bundles by clicking on the export button. And lastly, we have the test series reports. The test series are a collection of test sets. Each set will have multiple mock tests. For example, you can have a test set called GMAT and have 5 tests on reasoning. You can have another test set called Quants and have 5 tests on quantitative aptitude. The overview section shows how many sets and tests have been created and published. Next comes the set score distribution. This graph will show the average score secured by your students across each test set. The test score distribution will show the scores secured by most of your students in tests appearing across all the sets. By default, average score across all tests within a test set will be shown here. To view the scores across individual test sets, click on the All Sets drop-down and select the test set. To get more insights on how your learners have performed within each individual test, click on the Tests. This will take you to the mock test reports that we had explained earlier in this video. With this, we have come to the end of the learning analytics report. Let us know, what analytical data do you use to measure your student performance in the comment section below. And lastly, if you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to our channel, and hit on the bell icon to get instant notifications on the latest features of Learnyst products, course creation, and marketing tips. So until next time, see you, take care, and bye-bye.